Right at the convergence of the Three Rivers on Art Rooney Drive, we welcome you to Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City, and a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call with the Minnesota Vikings. They go play action here on first down. And he'll be out of bounds, getting it across the 25. The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards. That's a matchup maybe they go back to their outer third of the field as this game continues.
Yeah, I think back to my high school coach, John Ford. He used to say when we got big plays early in a game or good plays, you know, he'd say, foul it away, lad, foul it away, because he'd want to come back to it later in a key situation. They may come back to this one a little more often than that.
Didn't he say laddie or did he say lad?
Yeah, it just depends on what he was feeling at the moment.
Okay, I thought that was the guy you told me about that used to say laddie a lot.
Laddie, when you heard laddie, he was usually in a pretty good mood. Lad, yeah.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. And this is caught by Martavis Bryant. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. The reception good for 7. It's third down. I think defensively you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
The Steeler first down on the pickup of 11 yards.
Tremendous blocking by the interior of the offensive line. They didn't just gash him there. They blasted a gaping hole for him to gallop through. And if he comes back to the huddle, he better be giving them a whole lot of credit and thanking them for that much space to rumble.
They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And he's got his man on the out route. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
On second down, Roethlisberger. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for his big tight end there, Jesse James. And it's third down.
I know one thing, Brandon. This was a very difficult defense to throw the ball against in 2016. What were they, third in the league in pass defense?
Yeah, these receivers are going to have to be sharper with their routes in this one.
Yeah, because they're going to show them a lot of change-ups in the secondary, and they have a good pass rush.
Third down, Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Give him 30 yards there.
In order to be a great player, you have to be consistent. Antonio Brown is definitely that. 4 straight seasons with 100 or more catches.
How many more years do you think he can put up that type of production?
I think at least another 4 in a row, because their offense is built to get him the football, whether it's outside, inside, and he's a featured guy, and I think that he really, really wants to continue at this pace.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll make this a 2nd and 13.
That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats, but really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him.
Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line, Linval Joseph. able to drop him for a loss of a couple.
You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Looking deep downfield. He's got his tight end. That's James. Touchdown, Steelers. Jesse James, 31 yards. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. Just how they wanted to start this one in the end zone on their first possession.
And that just happened. How about that play right there? As you said, opening possession, setting the tone for everything. And I'm going to look forward a little bit now because everyone should be celebrating his catch in the end zone. The tight end gets a little bit of love. But if you're a receiver on the team, you should be thinking to yourself, boy, oh boy, things are going to open up the rest of the game if they have to focus on him as well.
Well, on now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. And now out comes Minnesota. First and 10, Bradford. It fights him off, shrugs him off. And his first look is incomplete. Charles, already trailing by a touchdown early. This offense, how imperative is it for them to get points out of this drive?
Well, they feel like they have to go ahead and match because of what was already on the board against their defense. But I think even more so, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
A second down throw for Bradford. And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going to go down. Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that one looked pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
What you call a hit stick. Put down to the ground hard. No gain on the play there. Second down. A well-executed blitz, no doubt. Great job by the linebacker. Maybe the quarterback, if he could have seen that, could have audibled there.
Yeah, he needed to be in a different play because that one just meshed perfectly for the defense. All the gaps were filled except for the one the offense really wanted to run through, and that was filled by a big man wanting to make a tackle.
And he made a great tackle. Now Bradford. Left side caught by Diggs. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up the touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series. Brandon, just mark that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. That was second down run for Murray. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Throwing, Bradford. And he's got Kyle Rudolph. Bradford finding Rudolph there for a Viking first.
I don't believe that this opening drive is surprising to either one of us after the time we spent with the coaching staff and players prior to the game. What about you?
Absolutely. Not only that, but that big article in this paper this morning about their philosophy on starting games like you're shot out of a cannon, and that's what they've done. Very methodical here on this first drive.
Yeah, so many teams talk about that fast start. We're actually seeing it happen right here in front of us.
But now the kicker. Can they cap it off by putting the ball in the end zone? Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll bring up a second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Now a second down throw for Bradford. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. That'll set him back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that'll lead here to a third down. And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Bradford again. And Rudolph has it left side. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
On now is Kai Forbath to try the field goal. This from 54 yards away. And did he have enough? He did. He kept it online and managed to tuck it into the bottom right corner. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
Well, it's not unusual to know that Kai Forbath has kicked for multiple NFL teams, right? Washington, New Orleans. They took over the Vikings job when Blair Walsh ended his tenure there when he was struggling. How about his start with the Vikings, though? Made 15 straight.
Yeah, he took over in week 10, and you're right, hit every field goal the rest of the season. Forbath now to kick it away after the made field goal. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for four quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade sixes for threes, things are going to work out in your favor.
They'll start the drive with a carry by Bell. Yeah, he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
After the penalty, it's Bell. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. It's a gain of 3, and it'll be second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. They'll go again with Bell. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, and that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Now Ben on third and long. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, no second guessing the call here. It was third and long, so throwing the football was probably the smart play to try and pick it up. But they don't get it, and now the defense goes off the field feeling pretty good about themselves, gaining some momentum as they force them into a likely punting situation.
On fourth down, here comes a Steeler punter, Jordan Berry, to kick it away. Marcus Sherrill's back deep for Minnesota. And the fair catch is made at about the 27-yard line. 51 yards on the punt there. And it'll be Viking football here as they take possession. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them.
Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down. Bud Dupree able to get him for a loss of about 3.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
With a give to Murray. It's a 7-yard pickup. They'll be looking now to 3rd and 6.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jarek McKinnon. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Give him 3 yards there as that'll take us to 4th down.
Now that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
Ryan Quigley, 5th-year man from Boston College, in to punt it away. Back deep for the Steelers, Antonio Brown. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. On 1st down, it's Roethlisberger. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. The completion good for 3, and it's 2nd down.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
A little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Now Roethlisberger to throw on second down. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, nearly picked. And maybe lucky there. This guy doesn't drop many defensively. Third down.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum, big play, right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. From the gun on third down, it's Roethlisberger. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
Can't fault the offensive line for that incompletion at all. He had all day to throw the football. Their alarm clocks went off early today, didn't they?
Absolutely, they did. He was surveying, finally let it go, but incomplete.
Here's Jordan Berry now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Here's Sherrills. And now running right through it. Call that a 46-yard punt with a net of 40 on the 6-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now the Vikings offense gets set to take over here. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well, and maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
He was looking for Adam Thielen there, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
Throwing again, Bradford on second and 10. And he comes back with one complete. A gain of 39 that time.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that, have explosive plays, that's often the difference in winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
A first down throw for Bradford, going with a screen for Murray. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Got to give some credit there defensively. They snuffed out that screen early on first down.
Really read it well, didn't they? Because they didn't bring the pressure that they expected. They covered all the passing lanes. So once you see it break down as the passer, I think in this situation, you're throwing it in the feet of your back to make sure no one picks it up, or you throw it away, throw it over the sideline. Don't try and freelance and try and make a bigger play. There's really no one else running a pattern that should be open. They always say that real estate is about location. Well, guess what? When it's a slant route, the quick ones, timing. Got to be able to lead your man with the football.
And the timing off right there, threw it behind him. On third down, Bradford. Caught on the right side by Treadwell. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. And Forbath will put this one through, and they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. Forbath now to kick it away after the made field goal.
On the return, Fitzgerald, Toussaint. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And the Steelers set to take the field.
I would say they went three and out last time, but actually they didn't even get to three and out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go one and out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try and play field position maybe, turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense. Who knows?
You're a nice man.
Throwing now, Roethlisberger on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's James. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. And the offense lining up first and 10. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. This is Bell on the dump off. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make it second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now it's Roethlisberger. Got his man complete over the middle. It's James. And he is going to be knocked flat on his back. Oh, a big hit at the 47-yard line.
Jesse James, 10 catches, 131 yards in the Steelers' 2 playoff games last year. A more than reliable tight end. A guy who can create big-time plays downfield. But let's face it, partner, you love calling that name in a game, don't you?
I do. But as we saw right there, he's really reliable on third down, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Jesse James.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. They go play action here on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Call it about a gain of 3, and they'll be looking at a 3rd and 7 coming up.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
The Vikings on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 7. Bradford. Screenplay, McKinnon. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there.
Well, the screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second, it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Six-yard boot, but just 36 following a pretty decent return of 10 yards. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Play fake here on first down. It's complete to Brown, right side. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
There's no doubt about it. That's just one of the best connections in the league. Big Ben throwing it to Antonio Brown. And Antonio Brown has turned himself into such a player, a low-round draft pick, but you can't beat his determination or work ethic, and Big Ben welcomes that.
And Big Ben won a Super Bowl at 23, youngest ever to do so, has never looked back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 14 yards and a Steeler first.
Well, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral, also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
And they'll keep it on the ground with Bell. And he's got some space here. And out of bounds all the way down at the 2-yard line. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll try to run it. This is Connor. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage.
And Anthony Barr just has it all, as far as I'm concerned, in terms of physique, athletic ability, and now he's versatile as well. When he came out of UCLA, he'd played outside linebacker, but also down defensive end. The Vikings can utilize those same sort of skills.
They stay on the ground. Here's Connor again. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
Roethlisberger, that's complete, right around the 8. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering it. Just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers field goal try. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And Boswell's kick is good. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. So it's only 3 points on this opening drive of the third quarter. And even though that stretches out the lead, Charles, I think you'd have to consider this a win for the defense, no?
Couldn't agree more, Brandon. That offense got themselves in prime position to really open up this ball game, but the drive stalled out. And yeah, 3 points is very easy to get back in today's NFL.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. Fielded about a yard deep. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. 9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on 2nd down. Now Bradford on 2nd down. Over the middle here to Rudolph. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. That catch good for 5. It's 3rd down.
You talk about a combo that works really well. Sam Bradford, short, dart-throwing quarterback, and Kyle Rudolph able to work the seams inside and make those tough catches.
Now Rudolph wound up shattering his career high with 83 catches last year, 3rd among NFL tight ends. Bradford from the gun on 3rd down. And this is going to be incomplete.
Now we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. Here's Ryan Quigley now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. This one hits at the 3 and then bounds into the end zone for a touchback. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Here's Roethlisberger to throw. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Eric Kendricks in from his linebacker spot. He's able to drop him for a loss of about 10.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
On 2nd down, it's Bell. And an alley to run. It's a pickup of 17 there. And it'll be 3rd down.
It seemed like the situation was 2nd and a mile to go for a 1st down, which screams what? Throw the football. You got to pass in order to try and pick up that kind of yardage. But in this case, they ran a tendency breaker because the tendency is for defenses to be out there and be set up for a pass. So you break tendency and actually run the football. That changes everything, because if you're able to find a crease, you often have bigger guys working against smaller guys downfield. They picked up excellent yardage there to bring up a 3rd down.
The gain of 4 that time as the drive continues.
It's always been funny to me, Brandon, when coaches always talk about on hot days like the one we have here, well, it's hot for both teams. But when one team has the advantage, when one team is running the ball really well and closing things out, it's hotter for the defensive side, and they sag a lot quicker.
Yeah, they say the dog days of August, the heat we're seeing here today, dog days of September, and the advantage right now on the offensive side. Now a 1st down carry by Bell, and he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
Now Roethlisberger, and they will set up shop in enemy territory at the 42-yard line. A critical error there in a tight game of the 4th.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the 4th quarter. turning it over. Now the door is open for the opposite.
Oh, no, he lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet there are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. Now Roethlisberger on first down. Over the middle, complete. That's James. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The passing game in rhythm right now for Pittsburgh. There's another first down. Bell. Now it's Roethlisberger. Bryant with a catch right side. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Roethlisberger with a give to Bell. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through 3 quarters, no reason to lighten up now. On second down, Roethlisberger. One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Got his man, it's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, a 12-yard touchdown grab, and the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. Well, he wasn't the guy they were initially going for, but after going through the progressions, it worked.
When you have plenty of people who can catch the football, you don't always have to go to your primary target, and sometimes that target is actually covered. Nice job coming off of that and getting it to someone who was open.
And a man out of the backfield gets in for the score. Well, on now to kick this one away. This will be fielded at the 8. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Vikings offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here?
Incomplete. Right side, the tight end Rudolph. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Decent start to the drive there. Of course, they need the touchdown, two-point conversion, and a field goal.
Yeah, those guys are into it. How about the guys on the sidelines? You see the coaches signaling, all the personnel groups up on the sideline, ready to go in and out of the game. They've got to condense their time now in order to try and get back into it.
Bradford, draw play. He gives to Murray. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I can just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. First down, Bradford. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. The first down screen pass, good for 5. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
Now a second down throw for Bradford. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his tight end there, Kyle Rudolph. And it's 3rd and 5.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
The Vikings on 3rd down. They've had their troubles, just 1 for 6. This will be 3rd and 5. Bradford to throw it. And that is incomplete. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. So with that, we can just about close the book on this one, Charles.
Yeah, what's the old expression about Slim and none? Well, Slim just left town on that one.
They're down to none?
Yes, exactly right.
Roethlisberger going to hand a bell, and he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. The Steelers' offense now, they head back onto the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really looked clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
Again, it's Bell. And he'll take it inside the 40 to the 39-yard line. Another timeout called by the Vikings now. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. The Steelers on 3rd down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. They'll try and run for it with Bell. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. It'll be their 3rd and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. And with things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Roethlisberger. And he's got Rodgers. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. The Steelers able to pick up 18 yards there. Well, we looked at each other in surprise going for it on fourth down in the fourth quarter with a lead. But, hey, you get it as a coach, you look like a genius.
So the next time we see Coach, he's going to say, well, that's why I coach and that's why you guys talk up there, right? He had the guts to go ahead and go for it, and it paid off.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. He didn't even try to signal for a timeout, so they must have not been aware of the numbers.
I think he lost track of the time left in the play clock and probably was trying to read the defense and trying to figure out which play to run and just lost track, and it cost him.
And the knee is taken for the Steelers out of the victory formation. Roethlisberger dropping to a knee, and that ought to do it. And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com.